My name is Christopher, and when I was 2 years old, I was diagnosed with autism.
The day I realized Christopher had autism came shortly before his second birthday. Christopher's speech therapist, Louisa, sat with me on the couch while we watched Christopher line up rows of plastic animals, ordered by size and kind. For many months now, I'd waited for Christopher to talk. I lay in bed each night, imagining what his voice would sound like. Christopher was always so quiet. Now, I asked Louisa what she thought was wrong with my son. She said he might have something called PDD. After Louisa left, I searched for PDD on the internet. The same word displayed again and again. Autism. Though it was unbearable to think of Christopher in this way, it didn't take long before I understood the truth. My son was autistic, and though I didn't know it then, in the years to come, two more of my children would also be diagnosed with autism.
A little over a year ago, Christopher sat the exam his parents dreaded.
Yes.
Unfortunately, he passed with flying colours.
Do this.
Christopher was diagnosed autistic.
Yes, you did a good job.
I don't even really remember exactly what I did after that, but my husband came home that night and we just sat on the couch and we just sat there and cried and cried.
Heather had known something was very wrong. Christopher's behaviour was obsessive. He flapped his hands maniacally, didn't speak, and screamed if anyone tried to reach him.
This was an absolute war on his part. He was saying, I want to be in my own world, leave me alone. I don't want to do what you want me to do. And he just screamed and screamed and screamed.
Christopher, what's your phone number?
968-735-3963.
Nice job, you get a penny.
But just look at this little autistic boy now.
It's a penny.
Excellent.
He looks them in the eye, he speaks to them. And now he's learning to learn.
Can you give Ellen a kiss for me?
Maybe.
Oh, good.
Our story is not about a magic formula or a single approach in healing our children's autism. Rather, it's a story about a lot of failures, followed by learning and change, and an acute awareness of the unique needs of each of our children. Mike and I established our philosophy early on. We scoured the research and used the data as our guidepost. We brought in experts from all over the country and were never satisfied with only one opinion. If our children failed to respond, we learned more and tried harder. We worked only with people who were as dedicated to helping our children as we were, and rejected all others.
When I was diagnosed with autism, the doctors said I would never learn to speak, but my parents didn't believe them. Instead, they figured out how to teach me. 3 years later, I was no longer autistic. Sometimes I wonder what my life would be like if I couldn't speak or didn't have my friends. It's hard to even imagine.
Love remains the same. Find a place where we escape. Take you with me for the space. The city buzz sounds just like a fridge. I walk the streets through seven bars. I had to find just where you are.